to start out, we need to create a new Laravel project. So I have my Laravel installed globally, so I can do Laravel new. I'm gonna call it Multi-Auth admin panel basic. I know it's a long name, but it keeps me organized. So that, and then we're also gonna add the jet tag at the end so that we get the Jetstream defaults with it. So which Jetstream stack? We're gonna do Inertia. And no, we're gonna create our own teams or our own admin functionality. Now that that's done, we can go ahead and cd into the project. Doing two commands here. That code dot is gonna open up the Visual Studio code, and this cd is gonna just cd us into the new folder. Now that we're in, the first thing I want to do is head down to the webpack.mix.js and add a new field. And this one is just to disable the notifications that pop up with Laravel Mix. Okay, the next thing I want to do is make sure that my .env files have the database name already set. I've already created the database, so that's the name of mine, and then just add your root and password, and then you're good to go. So close that out. Let's take a look at the database migrations and open up the user one. It should be the first one. Okay, so the first thing we need to do here is add a new field, and it's going to be table boolean, and we're going to call this one is admin. The next thing I want to do is head over to the user model and add that field. So user model, and then we'll scroll down to the fillable and add that right in here. So is admin. Now to seed our database, we are actually going to be using factories and seeders. Okay, so user factory, we'll come down here, we'll add that is admin to the factory that we have here for user. So copy paste, and we'll say is admin, and then we'll just hard code it 0. Okay, so all this is admin is doing is basically just saying it's just making a check. So if the user is an admin, then they'll have 1, and if not, then they'll have false. The next thing we can do is we can close up this users, and we can close up the factory. Okay, let's just start adding in the role information. So new terminal, open this up and make this a little bigger. Okay, and then we'll do PHP artisan make model role, and we're going to need a migration and factory. And we also need a seeder, so we'll do all of them at once. And while we're in here, we can also make a controller, PHP artisan make controller. We'll put in admin folder. Or admins role controller, and we'll make it resourceful, and we'll also add the model equals role. Okay, so while that's doing that, let's go ahead and work on this migration. So the only thing we need to add in here is a table string, and we just need a name for the role names. Okay, let's go ahead and also add that to our model. So protected, fillable equals name. So we can also add our relationship to the user. So public function users. Return this belongs to many, and then we'll add user class. And the reason we're doing it this way is that in case you want to add many roles to one user, then you'll be able to do that with this belongs to many. Okay, so we'll grab this and put the inverse in the user model. User, scroll down, add that here, change this to roles, and change this to role. So now, in order for this to work, we also need to create a pivot table. Okay, so how we do that is PHP artisan make migration, and then we'll call it create role user table, and create equals role user. And the reason you do it like this is it's a naming convention. Anytime you create pivot tables, you want to make sure that they're in alphabetical order. So role and user, these are the two relationships that we are representing in the table. R comes before you, and that's how you name this. And you also name them singular, so that it's just a naming convention to not confuse you. And if you change the way you do it, then you have to add an extra field in the models to specify which table, what your actual table name is. But other than that, this is how you would do it. Okay, so enter. Okay, so let's head down to the migration. Okay, now you see it's role user. And when it drops, when we pull it back, if we need to reseed it or drop the table for any reason, then it's role user. Well, that's the correct table that will be dropped. Okay, so the first field that we want to add is table foreign ID, and the first one we'll add is user. Well, I guess it really doesn't matter here, but we'll put role ID. Constrained on delete cascade. And all this is doing is just creating a foreign key for the role user table, and this will link them in the database. So if it drops, if we end up dropping the database, it'll also drop the all of the tables associated, the relationships associated with it. So copy paste, and we need one more for user ID. Okay, so before we set it up to migrate, what I want to do is we can close out these tables, and we can close out the models. So what we can do now first is deal with the factory. So the role factory, it's easy, it only has one field, which is name. And so we can put name equals user. We're just going to hard code it, because then we're going to be able to switch it once we get everything set up, from user to whatever, moderator, whatever. Okay. Now we can head into the seeders, and we do need a table, a user seeder. So actually, let's PHP artisan make seeder user seeder. Okay, and so while that's doing that, we'll open up the role one, and then we'll add our values in here. So the first one will be a role. We want to make sure we import that up top here. Okay, role create name equals, first one will be super admin, and then we'll copy paste, and this one will just be admin. This one will be developer, and this one will be moderator. So now we can close both of these out and head into the user seeder. Okay, and start building this out. So in this seeder, I'm not going to create another seeder to connect the roles and the users. I'm just going to use this one. So we'll create a variable, super admin role equals role, import it, where name is super admin first, and these are just eloquent relationships, so we can use them in our factories and seeders as well. So copy, okay, and this will be just admin role, where admin, the next one will be moderator role. And I'm not putting these in any particular order, I'm just doing them off of memory. So moderator, developer, and developer. Okay, so let's define that here. So super admin, it'll be another variable, equals user. Let me import that. And my editor, I have an extension that helps me to auto import these, but they're right up here, and these are the values for those imports. So user, create, open that up, and it'll be name equals super admin is admin equals one, because they are admins. Okay, email equals super at admin.com. And I usually like to do super admin and admin have just complete authority over everything, or at least super admin does. And then maybe you want to downgrade some of the permissions for the admin role. But that's how I do it. So email verified at equals now password equals, we'll import hash, and this will just hash the will hash the passwords for us. So make, and the password that it's going to be hashing is password. Okay, and then remember token equals string random 10. Okay, so it'll just give us a random string of 10. Let's make sure we import that. And it's this one. Okay, so let's do that for the others. We'll copy this one. Paste. This one will just be admin. 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 Okay, we'll paste it again. And this will be moderator. And moderator. Okay, we'll paste it again. And then we'll do developer. Okay, and then we'll come down and create the relationships. So super admin roles attach, and we can attach because we have that new relationship. Super admin role. Okay, copy, paste, paste, paste. Now this is admin. Admin. Moderator. That should be role. And this one is developer. Okay, fantastic. So now we're going to head into the database seeder in order to call all of these. Okay, so we can move that up. We can uncomment it and just change it. This one is actually going to be role. And we don't need this. But we need has users. And we're going to add 100 users. And above that, we're going to have this call. And we'll say role seeder class and user seeder class. And what this is doing is allowing us to call the roles first, and then it's allowing us to call the user seeder class second. Okay, now this seeder, this user seeder is where we just added the relationships. Okay, so we need to make sure that the roles are in place first. So these four roles, these four admins that we have, we want them to be seeded before we seed everything else. Okay, so the roles first, then the users, and then the creation of 100 users with the role of user. Okay, because that's what we have here. So let's go ahead and try to migrate all of this and seed it and see if we broke anything. So PHP artisan migrate, and we'll also add seed. Okay, great. So now that everything has migrated and seeded correctly, let's go ahead and start our server. So PHP artisan serve, and then we'll also open up another one for our npm run watch. And watch. Okay, now that that's done, let's go to our browser, and we already loaded up the login page, which is cool. So now we can come to our database, we'll refresh it. Okay, and now we have all of our tables, and we have our users. Okay, so the first four are the admins, and everybody else is just a user because they have zero. Okay, and if we take a look at our, let's see, where is it? This one. Our roles, we have the four that we seeded in addition to the user that we, the user title that we seeded when we seeded the database. Okay, so I'm gonna leave it there for now. I will make sure to post what we have done up to GitHub, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.